People, on the historic date of 11th of January 1964, it was officially declared by the United States government that cigarette causes cancer. And within a day, an $8 billion tobacco industry and the incomes of 7,50,000 families was at stake. While most companies saw their sales dropping down, there was one company that miraculously went from having just 1% market share to becoming the fourth largest cigarette brand in the world in less than 1 year. And after 1970, when cigarette advertisements were permanently banned from televisions, this brand became even more popular to go on to become the largest manufacturer of cigarettes in the world. This brand that I'm talking about goes by the name Marlboro. And Marlboro today is so huge that it has got more consumers than its next 10 competitors combined. The question is, what the hell did they do? Because of which the very same cancer report and the ban, which is essentially supposed to kill its business, ended up becoming a stepping stone for Marlboro to become a $58 billion brand. The answer to this question lies in one of the most iconic marketing strategies ever witnessed by mankind, which is called as lifestyle marketing. Now let's try to understand this using a very simple example that is closer to home. If you are a 90s kid and you watched Sachin Tendulkar play, I bet you that at some point in your life or someone in your friend circle must have bought an MRF bat. And chances are that when you visited the store, you knew nothing about English willow, Cashmere willow. You did not care which wood the bat was made of. You did not care whether it was original or duplicate. You just wanted a bat. And then you had two choices, bats with no stickers and bats with MRF stickers. And you chose the MRF bat by default. And then after that, God knows how many years later, you realized that the full form of MRF is Madras Rubber Factory. And the fact that MRF is primarily a rubber tire manufacturing company, which just happened to sponsor Sachin Tendulkar. Later on, this very same thing happened to Reebok when Dhoni started using Reebok bats. Now here the question is it a coincidence that millions of children all across the country were so stupid to mindlessly buy a bat with a sticker of a rubber tire company? If not, then how the hell did this even happen? Well, here's where the magic of lifestyle marketing happens. We all idolized Sachin Tendulkar and we all wanted to be like Sachin Tendulkar. So subconsciously, the MRF bats made us feel as if we were holding the exact same bat as Sachin Tendulkar himself. So to put that straight, what we essentially bought into when we bought MRF bats is not the bat itself, but the connect that it had with our idol, that is Sachin Tendulkar, because we wanted to be like Sachin Tendulkar. Now in the US, the same thing happened to Nike's Air Jordan shoes lineup, wherein when Nike signed up Michael Jordan, the fascination for Air Jordan shoes became so crazy that even today, after 18 years of Michael Jordan's retirement, he still makes $100 million every single year just in royalty. This is what we call as lifestyle marketing, wherein consumers buy more into the lifestyle of the icon who's associated with the product than the product itself. And this is exactly what the marketers of Marlboro cigarettes did to their brand. After the 1964 report, which was released by the Surgeon General of the United States, brands started to do everything in their capacity to keep their reputation. Some brands tried to justify cigarettes, while some brands completely disapproved the very research itself. Back then, Marlboro was a very small company that made cigarettes only for women. But as soon as this news broke out, the parent company of Marlboro, which is Philip Morris, decided to shift their method of marketing and became an epitome of business propaganda in the 20th century. So what the marketers of Marlboro did is that instead of justifying smoking and using statistics that were difficult to understand, they came out with a campaign called the Marlboro Man, wherein they introduced a character who was supposedly everything a man wanted to be like, and they named this character the Marlboro Man. Marlboro Man was a cowboy who had a perfectly built up body, and the commercial showcased him as the ultimate archetype of manhood. He was tough, affectionate and stylish, and overall stood as the icon of freedom and manliness. And just as we kids bought into MRF bats, men of the 1960s were so fascinated by Marlboro Man and started buying Marlboro cigarettes that the commercial became a massive game changer for the company. And within a year, Marlboro went from having less than 1% market share to becoming the fourth largest cigarette manufacturer in the world. And the fun fact is, in all of those commercials, cigarette was not even the primary subject of focus. In fact, Cigarette as a product got less than 10 seconds of footage time in all of those commercials. And because of this, even when cigarette commercials were permanently banned from television and brands couldn't show cigarettes in their commercials on TV, Marlboro was very easily able to navigate through that situation because their focus was anyways not on cigarettes but on Marlboro Man himself. And that is how they were able to communicate their emotion very easily even through print and magazine. And this is the reason why even after the 1970 ban, Marlboro's business still kept growing. In fact, the sales skyrocketed because the rest of the brands were struggling to market their brands without showing their products. And that is how Marlboro became a legend in advertising and laid the foundation for Marlboro to become a $58 billion brand. Now, more than a business lesson, there is a very, very important life lesson that we all need to learn from this iconic case study. People just like Marlboro in the 1960s, even today, what we often fail to realize is that we are constantly being bombarded with lifestyle cigarette commercials that do not appear as ads, but in the form of pop culture icons. Now, this includes a James Bond appearance wherein he appears in a tux and symbolizes gentlemanliness, or Kabir Singh, who's portrayed as the epitome of manliness. Now, regardless of how lucrative they look, what is important for us to understand is that they are merely tapping onto your insecurities to convince you to do something which will give you a feeling as if you're an elevated version of yourself. But the truth is, because of your lack of self-awareness, you don't realize that your insecurities are putting money into their pockets, eventually to make those companies billions of dollars, but to turn you into a sick, miserable addict of either cigarettes or social validation depending on what you're buying into. So keep your eyes open and do not fall into these traps. And last and most importantly, my big brother's advice to you is, always remember that buying dumb shit will never make you feel happier or make you a better version of yourself. The only thing that will make you feel better is your acceptance of your insecurities and imperfections. And at the end of the day, if you do not embrace your insecurities, some billion-dollar brand will dig into your misery and make a fortune out of it. So think about it, and if you think I make sense to you, then help me spread this message by sharing this video with as many people as possible. And like once a great woman said, imperfection is beauty, madness is genius, and it is better to be absolutely ridiculous than to be absolutely boring. And if you learned something valuable, then hit the like button to support our channel. And for more such insightful business and political case studies, subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much. I will see you next week. Bye-bye.